The bird in front of you shouldn't exist in silence. It once thundered across New Zealand's ancient forests like a walking pillar, a creature tall enough to look over you without lifting a feather. This is the giant moa, the tallest bird the planet ever produced, and a reminder that you don't need wings to dominate the sky. 12 feet of muscle and bone, capped with a neck so long, it acted like a biological periscope. It scanned ferns, foliage and forest light from heights no other bird ever reached. Predators saw legs. The moa saw entire landscapes. Its bones were thick, almost architectural. A living scaffold wrapped in coarse feathers and built to haul its weight through dense underbrush. It didn't rush, it didn't glide. It simply moved, slow and deliberate, like a wandering monolith grazing its way through evolution's patience. And for millions of years, nothing challenged it. The moa had no natural enemies except one, the Haast's eagle, a raptor with a wingspan wider than a sedan and talons that could puncture bone. Their encounters were brutal. A silent forest, a shadow above. But the moa endured. It grew massive, multiplied into several species, filled every forest niche imaginable. From the lowlands to the mountain slopes, there was a moa built for that terrain. All of it unraveled in a geological blink. When the first Polynesian settlers reached Aotearoa roughly 700 years ago, the moa faced something it had no blueprint for, a predator that strategized, coordinated, and built tools. Moa populations collapsed rapidly under hunting and habitat burning. Forests shrank. Nesting grounds vanished. The giants fell first. And by the 1400s, the colossal birds that once shaped the ecosystem were gone. But what most people don't know is that one species didn't go quietly with the rest. A smaller, tougher cousin, called the upland moa, held the line a little longer. It lived in cold mountain forests where human travel was brutally difficult. Climate, altitude, and isolation gave it a few extra decades, maybe more. Archaeological evidence hints that while the giants disappeared early, this final species survived long enough to become a ghost story in the hills. A stubborn ember of an entire lineage that once dominated an entire island. Today, the landscape feels incomplete without them. New Zealand's forests grew around moa trails. Entire plants evolved defensive tricks specifically to avoid being devoured by their towering beaks. Even the Haast's eagle vanished shortly after its primary prey disappeared, as if the ecosystem itself sighed and folded inward. What's left are shadows, footprints caught in ancient mud, bones arranged like collapsed scaffolding, and a reminder that the largest bird to ever walk the earth didn't vanish from age or disease. It vanished because our species arrived with a different rule book. So when you look at this reconstruction, a giant that can only exist in pixels, plaster, and imagination, you're seeing an entire world that disappeared faster than it ever should have. Species end. That's nature's cycle. But some endings feel unfinished. And the moa is one of them. Because the real question isn't how a bird this massive went extinct. It's why we keep realizing, centuries later, that losing creatures like this leaves a hole nothing else can fill. And maybe that's the point. Not to bring them back, but to never let their absence happen twice.